saved me. You saved her.
She's already dead. I don't know if you can call what I'm doing saving her.
It's weird how things work sometimes.
True.
What are you gonna do?
Brad mentioned a nurse. His name is Derek Lee. He was there during Hope's surgery, and if I can get him to tell Brad exactly why his wife died, specifically that he's not responsible, then maybe I can help get him some closure. Hmm. What?
You realize this all started with you. Making me French toast. Yeah, tried it. It led to the accident, which led to Brad, which led to the hospital, which led to Hope. I mean, are we the puppet masters? Or are we just the puppets?
You know, I learned a long time ago, never question the cosmic law of French toast. I know.
But what?
He does this every day. Thomas is sending it to the ground, pulls it up before he goes to work.
Hi.
Hi. You want to buy a house?
Got one, thanks. You moving?
Yeah. I hate this house.
This is nice.
That's what she used to say.
Can I ask you something about Hope's surgery?
Put me in a good mood.
I know it's none of my business. It's just you were so helpful to Jim and me, and I'd like to return the favor.
You want to set me up with someone?
No.
Good.
I have this ability to help people during emotional crises. I'm not a shrink or anything, or a kook. It's just something I've always been able to do, and I would love to.
You know what? I don't need any help. I don't deserve any help.
Brad, wait!
You know how many houses I've sold since my wife died? Exactly none.
I just think it would be helpful for you to maybe talk to someone who was actually there when Hope died.
What's the point?
Because I think what's causing you so much pain is the guilt you're feeling because you weren't there.
I already talked to the surgeon and the hospital administrator. I even hired a lawyer who charged me $5,500 to tell me that whatever we accomplished wouldn't bring my wife back. So you just want to be like everyone else who tells me to get on with my life. Well, fine. How about you get on with